All right, hello everybody. Welcome to the episode of Fireside Brickie, the series where it's a lot of long-form commentary, a bunch of rambling, no honest discussion or topic, and I just kind of go at it. One rule for Fireside Brickie is you gotta get yourself some food, whether it's some food or drink, whatever the fuck you want it to be. You gotta grab that shit, you gotta come back, and then you gotta watch the series with that specifically. And today, we're actually playing Left 4 Dead 1. What an experience this is, and holy shit, the nostalgia is coming right back all over me. And I was actually looking to find what game to play for Fireside Brickie this week, and I was just kind of scrolling through my Steam library, and I looked at it, I was like, oh yeah, shit, Left 4 Dead was a thing. Holy crap. And so I chose Left 4 Dead. And I thought, you know what, I can get not only Left 4 Dead here today, but I can get Left 4 Dead 2. Next week, which is a lot of fun, and it just feels so fun to be back, like, just like this again. Just usual-ass Left 4 Dead fun times, which I didn't used to do, like, as of lately. I've been, you know, I played it a shitload back in the day, but as of recently, I have not played much Left 4 Dead. So if you are a Left 4 Dead fanatic, which I know some people are massive Left 4 Dead fans, don't expect any amazing play by me. I am a simple pleb when it comes to Left 4 Dead. I am not the best player, not even close, and I haven't played this game in like 3 years. Actually, I only played one match to warm up, so I really have not played this game at all. I remember the controls and everything, but goddamn, do I forget most to all of, like, actually the ways to play, like the special specific ways you have to play, like Left 4 Dead. You know, there's like specific strategies and shit. I don't remember any of that crap. I think there's a smoker nearby me though. Oh god! Wow, what timing was that? Anyway, so Left 4 Dead, man. So I remember when Left 4 Dead actually originally came out. Way back in the day, I don't know exactly what year it came out. It was pretty far back. I think is it like bordering 10 years or maybe not 10 years quite yet, but whenever it did come, maybe it is 10 years, fuck, I don't know. Because I played Left 4 Dead back in the day when, with, you know, Call of Duty 4 and Halo and shit like that, that's what I think was the case. Maybe Modern Warfare 2. Whatever it was, you know, it was kind of console pleb for myself, and I was, hey, Molotov. I was always playing it on, like, on console and shit like that, and I play with my friends, and we do four-man games, and, we play on advanced, mostly. We'd always attempt expert, but we can never actually win expert. We try, but we can never actually, like, get expert done. Oh, hi. We can never actually beat expert, which was kind of sad, because we just weren't able to beat it, and we tried so many times, and we could just never beat expert. And I mean, the only issue was advanced isn't like that difficult compared to expert. Like, expert is hard as fuck, right? At least I think it's hard as fuck. Some people like play hardcore mode expert in Left 4 Dead 2, and that's a whole new thing for them. But for me, as a casual player, someone who's probably wasting a lot of ammo right now, is that a pipe bomb? Ooh, pipe bomb. It was hard. It was really fucking hard. I think it's a boomer. Yep, I just heard the boomer sound. Found him! Jesus Christ, that scared me. I forgot the boomers existed. Big old fat dudes explode on you. Oh, Jesus. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. I don't remember. Oh, yeah. There you go, you can enjoy that. I think I saw a smoker over there. No. I think he's over here. There he is! You know, I realized that smokers are, like, really tall. Like, holy shit, are they tall. But, anyway. As I was saying, Advance was, like, a little bit of an issue with me. Because Advance was a little bit too easy, and Expert was just a little bit too hard. Is that another smoker? No, it's just a regular zombie. I was gonna smoke it for a second. Granted, oh, no, it's a hunter. Jesus Christ. Special zombies were always so scary. Anyway, I'm gonna be off topic. Me and my friends would always play this game way back in the day. And because of that, like, we had a lot of cooperative times and had a lot of fun that way. And we really enjoyed ourselves playing this game back on Xbox 360. Because when it came out, it was like, not really revolutionary to me. I think it classifies itself as survival cooperative horror. Even though, let's be perfectly honest, the horror part of this game is pretty much... Oh, god damn it. Shit. Oh, Lewis! Lewis! I can't see. I don't know what the fuck's going on. I think I just shot my teammates. Sorry. Alright, we're okay. But that was it was a very interesting and new kind of game when it came out. You know, I mean, it may not be the first of its kind, but I didn't really see very many games like... Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. Can I kill you? Come on. There we go. There were very few games of this kind at the time. You know, there weren't very many that were able to actually pull off such impressive cooperative, like, style shooter. Because this is one of the few games where, you know, like, it's cooperative, but it is, like, full cooperative. You... Oh! Oh, jeez! Okay, maybe there's a little bit of horror. Jesus Christ. You know, it was fully cooperative. You had to use your teammates. You get grabbed by a smoker, you get grabbed by a hunter. It sucks, bro. You need a teammate to come help you. Which also made the game a little bit difficult to get into nowadays, because if you're not like a veteran Left 4 Dead player, people don't want to play with you. There's no reason for anyone to want to play with you, because you need to be a veteran Left 4 Dead player. Like, you got to play this game for hours upon hours upon hours if you want to be able to play with roll with the big boys, right? Because I was just, like, if you're a noob at this game, people are going to hate on you. Because holy shit, it's hard. It's hard if you want to play, like, a really heavy level of this game. And if you want to play that really heavy level of this game, you need to do it in the sense of, like, just constant practice and learning and playing and all that kind of stuff over and over again. Let's get that closed. But it really provides, like, that skill ceiling, you know, for this kind of game. It's I don't know, it's a lot of fun. It really is a lot of fun, and there's a lot to the game. There's a lot of interesting parts to the game. There's a lot of detail into it. And then Left 4 Dead 2 came out pretty much being a sequel that's one of those sequels that's pretty much the original, but better in every way. At least in pretty much in almost every way. And it's just... It's good. It's a hell of a lot of fun. There we go. Get one of these. Keep one of those. Reload this. A lot of detail put into this game, too. Alright, let's get the hell out of here. Okay. You know, going down my Steam profile was kind of funny, because I was looking at all the games that I have uninstalled, just because I don't play them, being one of these games, like, I uninstalled Left 4 Dead Original because I just don't play it anymore, and I have Left 4 Dead 2 installed. But looking at my Steam library, I mean, this may be, like, a common thing, but the amount of games I have on Steam that I haven't played yet is way too high. It's simply way too high. I feel so bad. Because there are a lot of games that I just simply haven't touched on my Steam library that are good games. Like, some really decent games that I would really like to play. And I just haven't played them. And then you have these certain games that I have just hundreds of hours in. Like fucking DayZ is one of those. Uh-oh. That sounds like a smoker. Oh, it was a smoker. Like, DayZ has a couple hundred hours. Dead by Daylight has a couple hundred hours. What's this? Ooh, pipe bomb. Hell yes. You know, Chivalry Medieval Warfare has a couple hundred hours. Warframe. There are so many games that have all these hours, and there's so many games that I should be playing that I just haven't been playing. And I feel kind of bad, because, like, they deserve my playtime, some of these games. And it actually got... Oh, yeah, I forgot Garry's Mod. Garry's Mod's also one of those games. God, I played so much Garry's Mod. I wish I could play Garry's Mod with some people and make videos on that shit. Because, I mean, okay, let me be honest. Garry's Mod Games with Friends videos are probably some of the most overmade videos on YouTube alone. That there are at least, like 400 separate YouTubers. Like... 20 of them being actually big YouTubers that do nothing but Garry's Mod Games with Friends footage. Oh, wrong way. And just, oh, shit. Where's that hunter? And he's gone. He's fucking out of there. Whoa! There's also a smoker. Like, to me, there are just too many. There are just too many of those Garry's Mod Games with Friends things. And so, because of that, I have decided not to... Okay, I heard the sound of the... Oh god, here comes the horde. Yep. Yep, yep, yepity, yepity, yep. I threw it the wrong direction, too. There are, like, pretty much too many of them. And I mean, I want to make those kinds of videos. I mean, honestly, if I really actually wanted to make one, I'd make one. But none of my friends want to play Garry's Mod, and I kind of don't really want to play. I mean, I kind of do, I kind of don't. Because then you have to, like, if you want to play Garry's Mod with actual fun, you need to do Prop Hunt or Murder or Tumble on Terrorist Town. All those games you need a decent server for that who isn't filled with a bunch of kids and things like that and aren't annoying and people that aren't being assholes. And you see all the major YouTubers that do that kind of stuff play on servers where they can actually, you know, just enjoy themselves, or they own the server or something like that, where in the case of me, I have to like piggyback off of the kind of servers like that, and that makes it a lot harder for me. Oh hell yeah, I would get the auto shotty, but nah, I want to get the M16. All right. So it kind of brings me, it kind of drops like my want to do it a little bit because of that specific reasoning. But Left 4 Dead was one of those games that also kind of had the game. Actually, I don't make very many games with friends videos now that I think about it. I make only made a couple of those. I think the last games with friends video I made was like the Cowards one, I think, on League. Or did I make any Overwatch Games with Friends? I don't think I did, actually. Games with Friends, see, Games with Friends videos are fun, easy to make, and extremely entertaining. But at the same time, I just don't make any of them because I just don't really want to, honestly. I mean, there's nothing, obviously nothing wrong with making Games with Friends videos. They're a great medium. People love them. But just which button is, oh, it's E, right? It's just not really for me, in my opinion. I don't know, like they're the best kinds of videos sometimes. They're fun to make. Not only are they fun to make because you're just taking like fun moments of you and your friends, but because they're fun to make, they seem fun for the audience, and they're really easy to make. It's just highlights, you know. It's like making a stream a highlight that isn't a stream, and you can actually just kind of tailor it a little bit. It's really simple. But I just don't really want to make them, honestly. Is that a smoker? No, it's just some zombie puking. But I don't know, I kind of do. I do and I don't. I want to make them and I don't want to make them. It's such a strange paradox. Like, was it a hand cannon? Got a weapon here. No, it's just regular. Uh-oh. No, 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 no. There's another zombie nearby. Anything in here? Nope. Yeah, it's fun, but yeah. Oh, so on a totally unrelated topic. Like I said, it's a lot of rambling in this series. Oh, it's a tank! Oh, it's a tank! Oh shit! Oh shit, I made another mistake. Ow. I thought it was just a regular ass fucking zombie or special zombie. Ah! Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Alright, just, yeah, he's on fire. He'll die eventually on his own, but like, fuck. Oh, God, Francis. Oh, God, Francis, you're gonna die. Oh, he's dead. Alright, thank fucking God. Holy shit, that was something. I had no idea that was a tank. I mean, there was no way to avoid it anyway. It's the fucking tank, but still. Oh joy, free Molotovs. Ah crap, the door switch part. All right, give me the pills. Isn't there like one or two different kinds of like things you can heal yourself with here? Shouldn't there be like some kind of med kit around this area? I don't remember. Oh well. What was I saying? Oh, yeah. So I just started watching fucking Rick and Morty. Now it's kind of weird because I've seen many, many different scenes of Rick and Morty. I've watched many parts of Rick and Morty, like whether it be on YouTube or my buddies have shown me certain like pieces of episodes, but I've never actually watched like full length episodes of Rick and Morty. And I just decided to start watching the actual, you know, the actual show. And holy hell, is it hilarious. It is absolutely hilarious. I'm about 5 or 6 episodes into the first season. And I kind of like how it's a cartoon show that you can watch without necessarily needing context. Like, there is a story. It's one of those shows that has, like, a storyline with Jesus Christ. With its characters, but at the same time, you don't need that storyline to enjoy the show. You can just watch it. Please no, please no, please. Oh, God. Thank you. And so, I like that idea. And so, like, as the story progresses, I kind of feel like I'm not only invested in it, but I also, I'm watching the full, like, experience where it's like, I don't have to, the replay value is really good. But just watching it, like, some of these episodes, man, are just so fucking weird. Like, the Mr. Meeseeks? Meeseeks? I think Meeseeks? Whatever those things are called, you know. It's like, the entire episode is just fucking ear rape. It's just consistent grinding against my ears all the fucking episode. Hello. It's annoying, but goddamn, is it funny. And then... Stop it. Wait. Is that a witch? Oh god, there's a witch. Where's the witch? She's so close. Oh! Oh! Whoa! Jesus Christ! Okay, maybe this game is survival horror. Team? 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 Oh my god. Are you fucking kidding me? Are you fucking... Okay. Fuck. 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 Fuck this. Slightly tilted. Follow me, team. That is just plain tilting right now. That just... Wow, am I tilted. There we go. Team is back. There's that boomer. God damn it. That's the witch. That's the witch. That was the witch. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. I can't see. God ding dang diddly damn it. The fucking witch is right over there, man. She's right over there, man. It's over there, man. What the fuck are we gonna do now, man? We're some real deep shit now, man. Game over, man. Game over. Bitch, 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 bitch. Oh. All right, back onwards. Anyway, as I was saying, show is hilarious. Show is absolutely hilarious. I love that show. It just, all the episodes are just feel, it feels fresh. And I have no idea why. Like, I thought I'd get like a kind of Family Guy ripoff, maybe or something like that, or maybe like, I don't know, anything like those lines, anything like that. But yet it feels like a fresh show, and that feels good just in general. It makes me happy that I can get a show that feels so fresh and enjoyable. That's a smoker. I mean, it obviously it's not a perfect show, but I mean, if it's to have a single episode that I didn't like, and that's saying something, you know? Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh shit. Francis. 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 Someone fucking save Francis, you degenerates! Oh my god. Oh my good golly gosh right now. I'll get Francis up in a moment. He's... Oh. Okay, this is bad. This is bad news bears right now. This is bad news bears. Thank god these are just... I have pills popped. Sorry, Zoe. Alright. Heal ourselves. We're gonna skedaddle the fuck out of here. This game went from Rick and Morty to Rick and Dead. Rick and dying. Currently Rick and dying. Ammo here. I hear a hunter next to me. Alright, my team's with me this time. Are you fucking kidding me? Sorry. Open the door, open the door, open the fucking door! This is bad. I'm sorry, Zoe. Are you? Okay, we're okay. Are you? Help, help, Lewis, Lewis, Lewis! Fucking god, Lewis. Lewis, you're fucking tilting me. I don't remember Advance being this hard. This is not what I remember. This is harder than I remember it being. Fucking, I need pills. Oh! Thanks, Lewis! Oh, thank god, Francis. Yes? Hey, Francis, what's up? Oh, thank god. Oh, is that pipe bomb? Yes, it is. We got serious there for a moment. Not fucking with you again, bitch. Bitch. Okay. All right. Okay. Get in, please. Please get in. God, the AI in this game is so bipolar. It's either some of the best AI ever, or some of the worst. They either pinpoint shoot everything that you need to kill, or they leave you to die. It's one or the other. It's never... Eh. It's never been... I don't know. It hurts. It hurts me. The AI in this game hurts me sometimes. Okay, so this is what's gonna happen, kiddos. I'm gonna take a med kit and I'm gonna heal myself. And then I'm gonna take another med kit. And then... Yeah. Thank you. I'm keeping this auto shotty because the guns we have here are not as good. Wait, did I actually heal myself? Or did I heal someone else? I think I healed someone else. Fuck. Alright, kids, we're running on one health kit. Alright, here we go. Let's fucking go. Pain pills are my new best friend. Come on. I'm in, like, serious mode right now. Like, I gotta do it this way. I gotta do it the right way. I gotta scavenge. Is that a fucking tank? Are you kidding me? Ow. Ow. In excessive pain. Also incredibly slow. Well, this didn't last very long at all. Fuck off, random zombie. Okay, is it dead? No, it's not dead yet. Stop beating the shit out of Lewis. This is not okay. All right. Now get me up, please. Thank you. I'm going to heal myself. This time I'm actually going to heal myself. I think I used right click instead of left click, and it tilts me. It tilts me excessively. Okay, thank God. Start the lift and be ready to bite the horde. Well, you know, yeah, you know, fucking whatever. Suck my dick. I'm gonna get killed, aren't I? I'm gonna get karma'd, aren't I? That's a boomer over there. You can't be stealthy like that, big guy. They'll get up here eventually. That's a smoker. Seriously though, if you like adult cartoons like on Adult Swim and shit, watch Rick and Morty if you already haven't. I feel like I'm becoming like really, really late to this party, and I am. Oh God. Like I am extremely late to the Rick and Morty party, but it's a pretty fucking good show. I gotta be honest. I might watch some more of it later on, or later after this video at least. I got some shit I gotta do. I got some stuff I gotta clean up too. I had my friends over, or we went out for a night at the bar, and then I brought them over to my place afterwards. And we had a couple puking accidents, and so now I gotta go out. I mean, we cleaned up most of it, but oh my God. We cleaned up most of it, but I gotta go out and get some cleaning supplies and shit now because I just do. I just do. I just gotta. Okay, Francis. Yeah. So, gotta clean that up. That's not a whole lot of fun, but you know, you do what you gotta do. And I gotta do that. Not the most enjoyable shit. What the fuck? Where the fuck? Why the fuck did you go up there? I bet there's a boomer right beneath my feet. Maybe not. Maybe I'm okay. Alright, anything in here? Oh, yes, baby. Hell yeah. Thank God for that. You know, I actually, hey, another Molotov. You know, I actually really do enjoy Left 4 Dead 1, mainly for the characters and stuff. Okay, Lewis, my dude, I'm gonna heal you because there's a medkit over there. Okay, never mind, I'm not fucking healing you anymore. Zoe, you fucking heal him. Yeah, Zoe, you heal him with that first aid kit because, like, I'm not doing it because I'm the player. If I die, we lose. There you go. There you go. Good Zoe. Good person, Zoe. Good gal, Zoe. All right. So now that's done with. Oh, hey, there's a thing of pills here. Oh, okay. Of course, Lewis would take the pills. Of course he would. God damn it! Grabbing pills. Hell yeah! Grabbing pills. Fucking god damn it, dude. Takes the pills. I'm a selfish fucking hoarder of pills and shit in this game, but you know I kind of have to be. And, oh God, it's Hunter. Shot Lewis. Let's call him Lois. That is the sound of a special zombie. Or it's the sound of a horde. And now I'm being sandwiched. That is a smoker. No. Bad. Bad Zambinos. Speaking of Zambinos, without any spoilers or anything, I actually have a I have a funny video I'm gonna make, but after watching, I've been keeping up with The Walking Dead still. Some people have left it, which you know it's understandable. That it's not the show it used to be, but. Right now, in my opinion, it's really damn good, only because of Negan. Negan is like the coolest fucking character the show has had in the history of ever. He's just an insufferable douchebag, and it's awesome. But that's a witch. Nope. As my father once said, yeah, fuck that shit. I forget which way I'm supposed to go in this sewer. I actually completely forget which way I'm supposed to go. It's somewhere around here, though. But, you know, after watching a lot of it, it's kind of made me laugh a little bit, because I'm thinking to myself, huh, watching The Walking Dead, you know, enjoying The Walking Dead, watching the characters and everything like that, and I'm thinking, oh, holy shit. And I'm thinking, you know, once you watch the most recent episode, like I said, I'm not going to spoil the most recent episode, the mid-season finale, but after watching the episode, I was like, you know, I think Negan's actually the protagonist of this show. I'm pretty sure he's the good guy. I'm pretty sure we should be rooting for Negan here. And I think I'm going to do that. I was considering making a video on Monday just titled, like, Negan is the protagonist of The Walking Dead. That's it. And I thought it would actually be kind of funny. Because, I mean, I'm going to go through my entire reasoning as to why and everything. And honestly, after watching enough of it, I think he should be the protagonist. I'm pretty sure he's in the right most of the time. Okay, this was not what I wanted to happen. Okay, fuck off, I'm trapped. We're okay. Ugh, fucking hell. God damn it. There we go. So, that's probably a video I'm going to be making sometime soon, is why Negan is the protagonist of The Walking Dead. Maybe it'll be my Monday vlog. Maybe it'll be tomorrow's video. Who knows? I think it'll be a good time. I think it'll be decently humorous. Which is actually one of the reasons I thought it was, or one of the reasons for my last video. If you remember my last video, or not my last video, my last Monday vlog video was the I Got Placed in Silver 3 video, of course, which I have heard plenty of shit about, being placed in Silver 3, not because of the video. But after watching the video, I actually was like kind of pleased with how it came out. I was like, huh. It's like this, not only obviously it's just me being salty and shit, but it actually for me seemed like it was actually kind of a funny video. Like had a lot of jokes in it and you know, had a lot of different kinds of fun humor in it. I thought it was actually like a fun video. And because of that, I want to make more videos kinda like that. You know, more just kind of funny videos that maybe don't have to involve gameplay. You know? I don't know. That's one of the ones I want to do with the Negan video. So, we'll have to see. Alright, let's get in here, baby. Let's skedaddle. You did good. Look at me, Bricky, carrying this fucking team. Hell yeah. Forgot how long campaigns of Left 4 Dead actually is. Or are. They're pretty long. Oh, sweet. There's more. Right, I'm actually healing myself this time. And I'm going to take one of these. Thank you very much. And how do I do this again? All right, I open it up. I shoot all the infected out here. Reload. Open it up. Shoot some. Oh, I got my stuff stuck. There we go. And then shoot the rest of them. I think I remember some of the strategies here. Now for a while, I used to play this game only using the pistol. Because, like, oh hey, it doesn't have any kind of, recoil, or not recoil, it has infinite ammo. It's like, why would I ever not use the pistol? And then I soon came to the realization of, like, well, then what's the point of a primary weapon if you never fucking use it? So now it's mainly my secondary, as it should probably be. But still. Find it kind of humorous. I actually don't know what shift or binding I have for zoom in with this sight. Oh, hello. I need to figure that out. I need to figure out what zoom is. Wow, that is three special zombies all literally next to each other. I do love this weapon though, because of how just damn easy it is to just one-shot regular zombies. And you actually kill a lot of things really quickly. It's just the fact that has very little ammo. Here comes the horde. And there goes the horde. Whenever I have any major like form of horde coming at me, I just kind of like, oh yeah, you know, I'll just basically throw out a pipe bomb and then I win, in a sense. Everything dies, I'm fine. Boop. Boop ba-doop, boop boop ba-doop. No. Oh shit, that's a boomer. Some of these death animations are actually pretty good. Gotta give a little bit of props to the physics sometimes, even though sometimes they all die the same way. But blood physics was actually something that was always pretty good this game. Same with a game like Killing Floor 2. Right, I forgot the thing explodes. Oh, I'm out of ammo. There we go. I felt really good about that headshot. That was really cool. That was actually really cool. So how the fuck do I zoom in with this thing? I have no idea, actually. It's not a shift. Is it T or E or Q or... No, Q is switch weapons. I have no clue, honestly. Oh well, maybe I don't have it binded. Whatever, I can run with this without scoping. There's no real need to scope with this weapon. Do perfectly fine without scoping in. There's a lot of damage and the hip fire is pinpoint accurate. Boink, boink, boink. For a second I thought that these actual caution tapes legit blocked off the area. But they don't. But they did though. You know, wasn't this game banned in Australia or something because of its excessive gore and violence? Aren't a lot of games banned in Australia? You know, I thought of all places, Australia would be the ones that are the more tolerant to games like this. I'm surprised that they're not a fan. I mean, from the Australian people that I've met, and they say like cunt and everything so often. The language and stuff is all around the place, and they have a really sick sense of humor sometimes. Actually, have a really sick sense of humor. And so I'm very surprised that games like this get banned in Australia. I don't know, I don't really get it. Hopefully that ends soon, because no one likes to not be able to play games that are coming out. That sucks. You have to get it imported somehow or pirated, and that doesn't help the developers or anything. And that also sucks. It all sucks, man. Not being able to play a video game sucks, man. Video games are fun. Video games are my life blood. You gotta love me some fun video games. It is a good time. Alright, so we're just gonna drop this right there. Sorry, Francis, enjoy yourself. Oh yeah, I forgot about that wall. Gonna pop some pills. Oh, god damn it, Zoe. You had to like it like that, huh? You had to like it all vomity. You had to be that way, Zoe. You had to be that god. Oh shit. Alright, we're okay. Speaking of the devil. We're on the first floor, aren't we? So we gotta wait all the way until this thing comes all the way down. What a long time. That's a boomer. You know, these horde parts right here are actually really fucking hard on expert difficulty. Holy shit. Because they just consistently, like, send so many zombies after you. Get on the fucking elevator, I swear to god. There we go. When they send so many at you, it's like... when in actual, I think, expert mode, I think it's actually 10 damage a hit. Every time you get hit by a regular-ass zombie, it's like... What the fuck are you saying, Bill? Like, it is like 10 damage each. Doesn't a zombie come from the roof here? Pretty sure one does. Pew. Oh, it's C! Oh, C is zoom! Why the fuck would you put on C, which is normally the crouch button? And the control is crouch, but still. C. What the fuck? Alright. Uh-oh. It's a hunter and a smoker, I think. And there are a lot of special zombies in this game. Wait, that's not what I wanted to do. Come on, reloads. There we go. I think these zombies just are having a bad day at work. They're just like, God, dude, it's been a long day. I'm tired. I'm sleepy. I don't want to be here. I'm fucking infected. I've been working construction all day, all night. Why are these lights on? They're on so sporadically. Looks like an actual city, but you imagine the lights would be on a lot weirder due to the zombie outbreak. Or actually, maybe not. Maybe they'd be on totally normally because of the zombie outbreak. That actually makes sense. Why would they be on really, really crazily when everyone just instantly got killed? When no one's going around turning off the lights? You know, I answered my own question. I answered my own inquiry there. Pew pew. Wow, I missed a lot of shots there. Pew 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 pew. Okay. Okay. Let's just, try and be here, I guess. So as few zombies try to kill me, that like none of them actually arrived. Oh my god, that hunter ragdoll physics though. God damn. And now a boomer vomited on them too. Something is No. Get this fucking safe house. Get in the fucking safe house. Fuck you, tank. Fuck off. Woo. A woo. A woo-hoo-hoo. God, when you talk for so long, your voice cracks all the time. I was obviously trying to make a crack there, obviously, but still, it's like, Jesus. It gets me. Okay, so let's see what we got here. We grab a pipe bomb. We grab ourselves some ammo, and I guess I heal myself, and I grab myself a med kit. There you go. Here's the end. We're finally at the end here. Legit doing the rooftop finale. Damn, I did not realize that they were this long. They were okay, that was okay. I totally forgot they were a Left 4 Dead campaign is this long on advanced, that is. Imagine how long it is on expert. Probably takes shit way slower. I wonder if like any major. Wow, God, my voice keeps fucking cracking today. I wonder. Fucking hell. I've been up all night. That's probably why my voice is all fucking scratchy and shoddy. Oh, I earned achievements. All right. Though, to be fair, I do wonder, like, if perhaps maybe, or any Left 4 Dead players, at least in the chat right now, or in the chat, I can't think I'm Twitch streaming, any Left 4 Dead players in the comment section, can you tell me whether, like, what it's like being, like if you're, like, a Left 4 Dead player who plays, like, a shitload, like, for a living at this point, if you're just, like, a master Left 4 Dead player, like, expert, hardcore, is just your shit. Oh shit, Francis. Like, what is it like? Like, do you abuse the AI? Like, how does it go? Because I always thought maybe that the best players either go maybe really slow to make it easier, or they go really fast to abuse the AI so that they don't send as many zombies at them. Or, what are the tips and tricks that only a hardcore Left 4 Dead player would know? I'm very curious. I'm very, very curious myself. All right. Uh-oh, Lewis. Oh, God damn it. Lewis is alone. Yeah, you guys go get him. Yeah, you know, it's not like the hunter is ripping his guts out or anything. Lewis died. Fucking hell, Lewis died. Well, with that being said, we're gonna go ahead and just go call the thing now because this was a problem. Alright. Mercy Hospital, use the radio if you are there. And you know what? I am indeed there. Hello. Oh joy. The mounted gun. I'm prepared. I'm good, baby. Summon a rescue. 15 minutes? And here come the horde. Alright, we're gonna use the mounted gun for a little bit because I can. And then we're gonna have to probably bail from this mounted gun because this thing becomes a problem. Wait, we found Lewis? Oh, Lewis arrived. Shit, dog. I know Lewis randomly came back. He's like, yeah, I'm back. Yeah, you know, what's up, guys? How's it going? Oh, no. Shoot him. This is the opposite of doing that. All right. I'm going to try and heal myself right now. Please keep me alive. Thank you. Holy shit, that hunter. The ragdoll physics in this goddamn game are fantastic. Especially when hunters already have a whole bunch of momentum from their jump. I'm not going to use the mounted gun anymore. It seems like it could be causing more harm than good. Ah, damn it. Okay, well, I can just get up here and use my snipper rifle. Everyone does love a good snipper rifle. Though the tank is probably coming at some point. Oh, hello. Got him. Oh, sweet. Francis is healing Lois. Or Lewis. Not Lois. Lois is a different character. I'm actually really excited for next week when I play the actual, or Left 4 Dead 2. Because it has freaking melee weapons. And I love the melee weapons. And the blood effects in Left 4 Dead 2, I think, are way better in 1. At least I'm pretty sure they're at least a decent amount different. That's a tank. Wait a minute, he might knock us off. He might knock us off the edge, I forgot about that. Oh no, oh. And there went Lewis. Come on. What? Is it dead? Oh shit, died. Where's the boomer? Oh, we're okay. Oh god, here comes more. Isn't the helicopter close? Man, I'm not ready for this shit, man. Okay, maybe I am ready for this shit. Alright, we're gonna toss one of these out. Go get it, buddy. Everyone, go have fun. This is totally the thing you gotta all run at. Holy shit, that was a fucking hunter. Holy shit. This is getting more intense than I like. This is becoming more of an issue than I would have enjoyed. This is spooky. I hear like a smoker somewhere, I think. I think I do. Maybe a boomer or something. I don't even know anymore. Something is up and about. Alright, you can have those pills. I'm giving you those pills because you're Zoe. And you could use the pills. There's the smoker. I saw the smoker. You can't hide from me, smoker. I saw you and your shenanigans. Fuck off. I am not best at video game. But I am trying best. Alright. Oh no. Why did I know that was gonna happen? Why did I know that was gonna happen? I felt like that was... No. I just had a feeling that was going to occur. God. God. Fucking damn it. Okay. I should have kept the pills. Oh my god, the tank glitched. Oh my god, the tank is glitched. Okay, no, it's no longer glitched. That was hilarious, though. It was stuck in the fucking window. Oh. Shit. Come on, how much ammo do I need to put into this fucking thing? No, Francis! No! Oh, we're okay. Get up, Francis. Let me touch you sensually as I try to pull you up. Oh god, Zoe. Oh god, me. Fuck off! Okay, that's a hunter. Oh god, the hunter dropped Francis. Oh god, Francis died! Oh god, the helicopter's here! No. No! I have not come this far to die now! No, 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 no! No! Well, everyone, this has been Fireside Bricky. It's the Fireside Bricky. My name is Bricky. If you watch to the end, type grabbing pills in the comment section in all caps. And yep. Mm-hmm. All right, have a good one. Bye-bye.